And today we are going to begin the first chapter of your Flamingo book, that is the last lesson. The last lesson is all about the last chapter that is going to be taught in the school of L2nd Laurel. So without wasting time, let's begin the chapter. I started for school very late that morning. It was in a great dread of scolding, especially because MML had said that he would question us on participant. So as on that particular day, French started for the school very early, and he was expecting that he will definitely get a scold from MML, because MML has given the homework on participle and French had not prepared the participle. So, and I didn't know the first word about them. For a moment I thought of running away, spending the day out of doors. So as he had not prepared his work, that's why he was thinking that it is better to spend the time outside of the school, outside of the doors. It was so warm, so bright, the birds were chirping on the edge of the woods. It was a very bright day, and it is France, and in France, summers are very hardly welcome. So that's why it is written, it was so warm, so bright, the birds were chirping at the edge of the woods. The birds were also chirping over there, and in the open field back of the sawmill, the Prussian soldiers were running. And they were behind the open field, behind the sawmill, the Prussian soldiers, they were drilling very hardly, and it was all much more tempting than the rule of participles. So as he had not prepared the participles, so that's why he was thinking that it is better to stay away from school, and it was all much more tempting than the rules of participles. But I had the strength to resist and hurried off to school. But as his sixth sense allowed him, forced him to go away from there, and he hurriedly moved towards the school. When I passed the town hall, there was a crowd in front of the bulletin board. So when he was passing through the town hall is basically a building, and in front of the town hall there was a bulletin board, and the speciality of the bulletin board is that from the last 2 years all the bad news had come from there, like about the lost battles, the drafts, the order of the commanding officers. And I thought to myself without stopping, so he didn't stop over there and looked at the written board, but he thought all these things in his mind, and thought also, what can be the matter now? Why all these people are here? What is the matter for this particular time now? So this is the basically two paragraphs, and then I hurried by as fast as I could go. The blacksmith watcher, who was there with his apprentice reading the bulletin. So as he was going towards the school, in the way he saw a blacksmith and a watcher who was working with his apprentice, and they were reading the bulletin, and they called French and they instructed him, they told him that don't make so hurry, okay, you will be there very soon, you have plenty of time, work, you will be there in time, okay. I thought he was making fun of me, and reached MML's little gardens all out of breath. Okay, so he thought that he is definitely making fun of me, and that's why he, without noticing on his statement, he moved towards the school and passed the town MML's little garden. Okay, usually when school began, there was a great bustle which could be heard out of this in the street. What happened usually there is a very noise when the school began. But what happened that day, like the closing of the desk, lessons repeated in unison, very loud, with our hands over our ears to understand better. Sometimes we put our hands over our ears like this to understand the things no better. So similarly, all these things were going on over there. And the teacher's great ruler rapping on the table. The teacher was also putting his ruler on the table. Okay. So through the window, I saw my classmates already in their place, and MML walking up and down with his terrible iron ruler under his arm. So this is the class scene. He peeped into the classroom from a window, and he saw all the people, all the classmates were already at their places, and MMLs were walking here and there with his terrible, with his very cruel iron ruler under his arms. I had to open the door and go in before everybody. So what he was expecting, that by using this, the, the, that noise we can avoid the animals anger. But what happened? There was all around there is only silence. So now he was very much shy. He was feeling very much shy, and he was thinking that now I have to enter into the room in front of her. But nothing happened, and Amal saw me and said very kindly, "Go to your place quickly, little friend. We were beginning without you." But unexpectedly, MML didn't show any irritation, any anger, and he instructed French to go to his place without, and also said, "We are going to begin without you. It's good that you are here right now." So I jumped over the bench and sat down at my desk. He went there, jumped over the benches and sat down at his desk. And then till then, when I had got a little over my fright, did I see that our teacher had on his beautiful green coat, his French shirt, and his little black silk cap all embroidered that he never wore except on inspection and price dresses. So when he entered, when he became calm, cool, and relaxed in himself, then he noticed something unusual about the dress up of the MML. MML was wearing his best suit, he was in his embroidered cap, and all the things were there. So all these things usually he do when there is some prize days, or when there is some special days like the prize distribution days. Besides, the whole school seemed so strange and solemn, and in spite of all, the school was looking so strange and so quiet. But the things that surprised me most was to see on the back benches that were always in between the village people sitting quietly, like Asadur, Hauser, with his three cornered hat, the former mayor, the former postmaster, and several other besides. So this is also the case over there. The most unusual thing that he noticed about the presence of elderly people of the village in the classes, in the class at the back benches. And who were the people? Like the old Hauser was there, the former mayor was there, the postmaster was there, several others. Everybody looked sad, and the biggest thing was everybody was very sad. An old Hauser had brought an old primer, thumbed at the edges, and he had it open on his knees with his great spectacles lying across the pages. So this was all the day, and this was going on over there. When I was wondering about it all, MML mounted his chair, and he, in his grave and gentle tone which he had used to me, said, "My children, this is the last lesson I shall give you." So this was the message that MML has given, that this is going to be their last lesson in his very grave, in his very serious and gentle tone. The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. And he also informed them about the order that has been given from the Berlin and Lorraine, about Alsace and Lorraine, only German will be taught. So the new master comes tomorrow. This is your last French lesson, and I want you to be very attentive. And as it is going to be a last lesson, so that's why he was thinking, he was saying that, "Be very attentive." What a thunderclap these words to be. It was a great shock for little French, who the riches that was they had put up on the town hall. Now he reminded about that bulletin board of the town hall, and he thought, okay, so this was the case. Okay, so my last French lesson. Why I hardly knew how to write. Now it's the time when I had learned how to write the alphabet of the French language, and now we are not going to study it anymore. So I should never learn anymore. I must stop there. Then, oh, how sorry I was for not learning my lesson. He was repenting on himself, as he had not learned anything during his lifetime, like for seeking board sex, for going sliding on the sar. In spite of going to the classes, learning his lesson, he wasted his time with all the things. Like sometimes he was sliding on the side, sometimes he was seeking the words, like all these things. So my books that had seemed nuisance a while ago, so heavy to carry, my grammar and my history of the saints were old friends now that I could not give up. So the things that, the books that were very, you know, odd for little friend, all these things were very, very, very familiar, very dear to him. They all became very dear, like the old friends. And it's not very easy to give up, leave your old friends. So, and MML too, the idea that he was going away, that I should never see him again, made me forget all about his ruler and how crazy he was. So as he was not going to see MML, so this also shocked him too much, and he thought that it's not really very good, and he was very repenting in himself. Poor man, it was in his honor of the of his last lesson that he had put on his fine red Sunday clothes, and now I understood why the old men of the village were sitting there in the back of the room. So that is why now he understood all the concept, that that's why this poor MML has put on his best clothes that usually were on the prize distribution days, and that is why all the village men were sitting in the back of the room. So it was because they were sorry too that they had gone to school more. So it was their way of thanking our master for their 40 years of the faithful service and of showing their respect for the country that was theirs no more. So now the country, there is the domination of the other German people. So that's why their country is not no more of theirs, and the MML is going from there. So this is why, this is how they are, they have come over there to thank MML and also to thank their mother tongue, that is French. Okay. So while I was thinking of all this, I heard my name called. So all these things were going on in the mind of the French, and suddenly he recalled that his name was called out by MML. It was my turn to recite what would I have not given to his level to say that dreadful rule of for the participle. Now it was his turn to recite the rule of participle also, really loud, clear, and without one mistake. But I got mixed up. So it was his turn to recite about the participle, but he got mixed up on the first words and stood there. So in the very first word, as he didn't know even a single concept about participle, so that is why he got confused and couldn't reply. Okay, so holding on to my desk and my heart beating and not daring to look up, and it was not as when we are not able to reply at that time, our heads is often set down. I heard MML say to me, "I won't scold you, little friend. You must feel bad enough." So this was the instruction that he received from MML, that I will not scold you, little friend. You must feel bad. See how it is. Every day we have said to ourselves, "But I have plenty of time." So this is what the message of the chapter is. We have plenty of time. We can do it tomorrow. We can do it tomorrow. So we always used to postpone the things. And this postponing always affects a lot. So we should avoid all these things. So he informed all these things to little French and leave him to decide whether he had done good or not. And now you see where you have come out. Ah, that's the great trouble with Elsie. She puts off loving till tomorrow. Now those fellows out there will have the right to say to you how it is you pretend to be a Frenchman. And yet you can neither speak nor write your own language. How can you, means those who were sitting, the elderly people, those who were sitting there, how can you pretend that you are a French, true French people, when you are not able to write, when you are not able to speak properly? Then how can you be French? But you are not worst, poor little friend. We have all a great deal to reproach ourselves. We also informed that not only you, but also we, everyone, like me also, MML also just criticizing himself that he also had not served his duty very properly. So that he said that it's the fault of all, not only yours. Okay, so moving to the next paragraph. Your parents were not angels enough to have you learn. They preferred to put you work on a farm or at the mill so as to have a little more money. So this was the fault of your parents too, as they have always forced you to work to earn some more money. And I have been to blame also, and he also blaming himself. He is saying that I have always sent you to bring water for my flowers, and instead of learning your lesson, and when I wanted to go for fishing, did I not just give you holiday? And he had also given holiday whenever he was going to go for fishing. So then from one thing to another, I remember went on to talk of the French language, saying that it was the most beautiful language in the world. So thus he was recalling all his faults, all the fault of the villagers and everybody's fault, and was also emphasizing on the fact that the French is the most beautiful language in the entire world. So the clearest, the most logical, that we must guard it, we must protect it, and it is the most clearest, it is the most logical language among us, and never forget it. Because when a people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast to their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. So this is the basically concept. If we know our language, if we protect our language, if we communicate in our language, then definitely no one can slave us, no one can make us slave. okay, we cannot be student to anyone. So then he opened the grammar and read out our lesson. Okay, then what he did, he opened the grammar book and started to reading his lesson. He said, seems so easy, so easy. All he said seems so easy, so easy. I think too that I had given lessons so carefully. Now Frank is criticizing himself and he is saying that it is also my fault that I never thought about the French language very properly. Okay, I never paid attention on the French chapter. So it seemed almost as if the poor man wanted to give us all he knew before going away and to put it all into our hands at one stroke. So it was also, Emmanuel was also giving his best effort by doing all these things and wanted to pour all the knowledge that he has in one shot. Okay, so this was up to now. Now moving to a little bit more further. So this is what we have actually from this first part of the chapter. So after the grammar, we had a lesson in writing. So what happened after the grammar lesson? We have the turn of writing session. That day, MML had new copies for us. He had brought new copies written in a beautiful round and French Elsec. So all over there is French Elsec, French Elsec. It has been written. They look like little flags floating everywhere in the school room. So it like all the copies were looking like the little flags that were floating in all the rooms. And you all to have seen how everyone set to work, and that day everybody was very dedicated. How quiet it was, everybody was very quiet. The only sound was the scratching of the pens over the paper. The only sound was of writing the things on the paper, the scratching sound. So once some beetles flew in, but nobody paid any attention to them. So some beetles came inside, but nobody paid attention, and everybody was very busy with his lesson, learning his lessons. Okay, who worked right on raising beer fish hooks as if that was French too. On the roof of the pigeon coop, very low, and I thought to myself. So on the roof of that classroom, the pigeon were cooed and he was not paying attention on that also. So whenever I looked up from my writing, I saw MML sitting motionless in his chair and gazing first at one thing. Okay, so what was going on over there? Whenever from his writing, whenever little friends looked over and he looked at MML was sitting very motionless over there and was gazing at one thing to another. So why? Then at one, as if he wanted to fix in his mind, he wanted to fix all the things in his mind very properly. Okay, just how everything looked in that little school. Fancy, for 40 years he had been there in the same place with his garden outside the window and his class in front of him just like that. Okay, just think, from the last 40 years he was there in the same school with the same classroom with the same climate, but he was never so passionate. But today he was so passionate. On the desk and the benches had been worn smooth. Now the benches are very old, so they are a little bit worn smooth. And the walnut trees in the garden were taller, and the hawk vine that had planted himself twined about the windows. So the trees, they are growing, so they have grown a lot, and the vine also, they are moving to his room also. So how it must have broken his heart to leave it all, poor man, to hear his sister moving about in his room above. So his sister was packing all the things, packing up finally to went away from there. So it was giving him a lot of shock. Okay, and further he must leave the country next day, as they are going to leave the country very next day. But he had the courage to hear every lesson to the very last. Okay, so but that day he wanted to enjoy that particular period up to the last. And after the writing, we had a lesson in history. After writing section, they had a lesson on history. And then the babies chanted near Ba, Bi, Bi, Bo, Bu. Down there at the back of the room, old Hauser had put on his spectacles and holding his primer in both hands, spelled the letters with them. So old Hauser was also practicing with them. And you could see that he too was crying, his voice trembled with emotion. Everybody was in great emotions, everybody was crying, everybody was very upset that day. It was so funny to hear him that we all wanted to laugh and cry. All how well I remember it, that last lesson. So that was the last lesson. They were missing that last lesson very terribly. All at once, the church clock struck 12, so it was 12 in the noon. Then the Angles at the same moment the trumpets of the Prussians returning from drill. So they send the trumpets of the Prussians, they were returning from their exercises, sounded under the windows. MML stood a very pale in his chair. MML stand up from his chair, and I never saw him look so tall. So in the entire life I never found him so tall. Okay, but that day he was looking very tall. And then he turned to the blackboard. He turned to the blackboard, took a piece of chalk, and bearing on his with all his might, he wrote as large as a good Bible friends. He wrote the Bible friends in Bible friends. Bible friends means long live friends on the board. And then he stopped and leaned his head against the wall. And then he had taken the support of the wall, and he said, without word, he made a gesture to us with his hand, the school is dismissed. He made a gesture with his hand that the school is dismissed, now you can move out. Okay, so the school is dismissed and you may go. So this is all about the chapter. I hope that you have understood the concept. This is about the last lesson that you have studied. Thank you so much. If you have any query, you can put me into the school WhatsApp group. Okay, thank you, and stay home, stay safe.